Good morning, children. Let us learn about the history lesson 8, Vital Villages and Thriving Towns. In previous class, we have learned about the 3000 years ago and also 2500 years ago, they have used the iron tools. So today, let us discuss about who lived in the villages. There were at least 3 different kinds of people living in most villages in the southern and northern parts of the subcontinent. So here if you see, there were the at least 3 different kinds of people living in most of the villages also. That is in the southern and also the northern parts of subcontinents. In the Tamil region, large landowners were known as Vellalar. Ordinary ploughmen were known as Uzhavar. And landless laborers, including slaves, were known as Kadaisiyar and Adimai. So children, here, who are the people? Who are the 3 kinds of people living here? There are the landowners. Landowners are called the Vellalar. In the place of the which region? Tamil region. Ordinary ploughmen were known as the Uzhavar. And landless labor, those who don't have the land, and also the laborers, including they called the slaves, were known as the Kadaisiyar and Adimai. These 3 kinds of the people living in the villages. Especially now what we are learning, the in village 3 kinds of the people, especially in the Tamil region we have seen. Next one, in the north, that is the Tamil Nadu is located in which side? South. In the northern part of the country, the village headman was known as the Grama Bojaka. Usually, men from the same family held the position of generations. So, in a part of the north part, in Tamil Nadu, we have seen 3 kinds of people living in the southern region, in the particularly the place where we have seen now, the Tamil Nadu region. And here now, north part of the country, the village headman known as the Grama Bojaka. Usually men from the same family, if the father is a head, means even in the it is going to be included as the same Grama Bojaka, the son also. In the other words, the post was hereditary. The Grama Bojaka was often the largest landowner. The Grama Bojaka, the in a village, he is the person having the more land. Generally, he had slaves and hired workers to cultivate the land. So for him, for Grama Bojaka, workers are there to look after the land, to cultivate, to dig, everything. Just he will be commanding. The workers only will do the all work. Besides, as he was powerful, the king often used him to collect taxes from the village. In a village level, the king also will give order for the Grama Bojaka, and also he is giving power for the Grama Bojaka to collect the taxes. He also functioned as a judge and sometimes as a policeman also. The Grama Bojaka, if any problems are arising in the place of the village, Grama Bojaka will be looking after, and he settled the in gram or village level. In village level, any fighting, small discussions are there, he will be giving judgment for the, he will work as the police as well as sometime as a judge also. Apart from the Grama Bojaka, there were other independent farmers known as Grihapatis, most of whom were small landowners, and also they called the Grihapati. And then there were men and women such as Dasa, Kammakaras, who did not own land and had to earn a living working on the fields owned by the others. In most villages, there were also some craft persons such as blacksmith, potter, carpenter, and also weavers. So, children, who is living in the villages? In a Tamil Nadu, we have seen the three different kinds of the people are there. In northern part side, the Gramabhojaka, he is the maximum, the person who is having the more land and having the more property, and he is called the Gramabhojaka. And apart from that, after the Gramabhojaka, Grahapati also. He is the small land owners. Along with them, in a village, the people are living blacksmith, potter, carpenter, and weavers also. So this is the small information about the what we have learned about villages. In village, in southern, in the northern part, who are the people particularly living in the villages? So children, after listening the lesson, once again, you have to read the textbook also. So let us continue in the tomorrow's class. Thank you.